you can start with answer. It's, I think it's all about it's anthropology only. So firstly you want to know about current affairs, right? Secondly, how to anthropological view. So firstly the current examples, but firstly I used to follow that sir used to each day he used to update the the links of the current affairs. I used to go through that, and along with that what I used to do, I Google actually each and everything. Let's say Jajmani system. Google it. And in the news section, you will get an idea. Last year, even that question, indigenous debate, they asked. They asked about the debate of indigenous people's right versus the tribals in India. So that was also in the news last year. The 10th August, I think, indigenous people's day. On that particular week, Hindu, I think, have covered about extensively. It was 2 to 3 editorials they published, and 2 to 3 articles also they published. So that's how you need to go through that. Each and every topic you can go through that way. Even the Sanskritization part, they might not use the word directly Sanskritization, but you need to relate it. You need to see that, okay, even the last year's this movement, Patidar movement, or the Jat reservation movement, it's also related to the dominant caste and the Sanskritization at the end of the day. So whenever you are reading a news, you just try to relate it with your concepts. Even there's an issue in Haryana, there's an issue of Dalits were not allowed still in many places for doing the Ghur Chadai. It's for the Sanskritization. Dominant caste or the higher caste doesn't want that. If they also started following that particular rituals, they will have a parity that they don't want. So that's why they don't allow them. Even if they do, they generally try to penalize them, or they generally try to beat with them. So that's an issue. So in that, it's all about Sanskritization. And why they want to do, it's not that they will get something. It because they want to raise their status. That's equally good also. Everybody wants to raise their status. So you need to relate that way. Whatever is the news that you are seeing every day, just try to relate it with the concepts of the anthropology. And you will ultimately get an anthropological view. You will get that, okay, these are the things. And in a similar way, you need to, what are the questions? Second question, in the current anthropological view, how you want to, like the
impact of Panchayati Raj on women.
Impact of Panchayat, just talk, like, firstly, impact of Panchayati Raj on women, right? So, what we study in anthropology, we study that the social structure, the kind of social structure that we carry. So, initially in Indian society, women are not equal. Women were not considered equal, especially in the political sphere. So what happened with PRI, they were given an equal chance, or they were given actually equal platform with reservation that they will be coming into the domains of the political sphere. So that's how you need to show that how it is leading to the change of the social structure in the society. In a similar way, last year the question was asked on the impact of market forces on Jajmani system, right?
Market system leading to failure of Jajmani system.
मार्केटिज्म लीडिंग टू फेलियर हो जाता है. यू कैन राइट, यू नो आई रोट टू थ्री केस स्टडीज इन दैट. फर्स्टली आई सपोर्टेड दैट आइडिया दैट इट येस इट लीड्स टू द फेलियर. सर हैज शेयर सम वन आर्टिकल इन दैट देर वॉज अ केस स्टडी बाय द ऑटन एंड सिम्पसन इन सो ओडिशा. इन ओडिशा देर वॉज अ फील्ड वर्क इन विच दे केम अप दैट इन द रिसेंट पास दे वर नॉट द जजमानी सिस्टम इज नॉट एट ऑल फंक्शनिंग इन द विलेजेस. एंड अ सिमिलर केस स्टडी वॉज डन बाय फॉरगॉट द नेम इन द गुजरात विलेज वेर दे सेड दैट ड्यू टू द मार्केट फोर्सेज ड्यू टू द ग्लोबलाइजेशन पीपल आर मोर टेंड टू गो आउटसाइड एंड रेदर देन बींग इन टू द जजमानी सिस्टम. सो दैट्स हाउ द फेलियर. देन देर वॉज अ केस स्टडी बाय द जॉन हैरिस एंड वन मोर केस स्टडी वॉज देर इन विच ही सेड जजमानी सिस्टम इज स्टिल वर्किंग इन द कंट्री बट येस इट्स फॉर्म हैज़ ट्रांसफॉर्म. वट इज हैपनिंग टूडे दैट वी स्टिल हैव दैट काइंड ऑफ इन द विलेज वी स्टिल हैव अ रिलेशनशिप इन अ वे दैट समथिंग इट्स नॉट डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द थिंग्स बट इट्स रिलेटेड टू द सोशल रिलेशन दैट वी कैरी. वी टेंड टू बी कन्विंस बाई सर्टन सेट ऑफ पीपल मोर इजिली देन द अदर्स बिकॉज द काइंड ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस दे कैरी विद इट. एंड जजमानी सिस्टम इज हैज ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम एक्सचेंज ऑफ गुड्स टू द एक्सचेंज ऑफ फेवर्स और द एक्सचेंज ऑफ रिलेशनशिप्स. सो दैट्स हाउ द रिलेशनशिप हैव ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड. सो देयर वाज़ केस स्टडी इन कर्नाटका आई थिंक. सो दैट्स हाउ यू नीड टू टेक अ कॉल. यू हैव टू पुट गुड केस स्टडीज इन दैट पर्टिकुलर इन दीज काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन. एंड देन फर्स्टली तो वही यू विल स्टार्ट विद वट इज जजमानी सिस्टम विलियम वाइजर्स कंसेप्ट एंड देन यू कैन मेक अ डायग्राम ऑफ जजमानी सिस्टम विद एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डी एन मजूमदार स्टडी ऑन लखनऊ विलेज. देन यू कैन स्टार्ट अप विद बोथ द साइड्स. देन यू नीड टू कंक्लूड इन द एंड. यू कैन टेक अ कॉल दैट ओके येस जजमानी सिस्टम इज सर्टनली डिटेरियरेटिंग डे बाई डे एज द मार्केट फोर्सेज आर इंक्रीजिंग एज द रोल ऑफ मनी इज इंक्रीजिंग. नाउ द एक्सचेंज इज नॉट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ काइंड एट एनी प्लेस. इट्स मोर इन द कैश बट स्टिल द kind of social relations or the kind of social bonding that we used to have in the past, it is still continuing. You can conclude by that. So in a similar way, you have to anthropological view, ultimately it will come. You have to use some certain terminology. So just think in that way, what you study in the anthropology, what we study in that, it's all about social structure. Jajmani system is also about the social structure. That's how our society is structured. Again, functionalism, structural functionalism, that's how you need to relate. It's everything is related. Even Sanskritization is structural functionalism. They want to maintain a structure, that's why they are doing all these things. So you need to come up with, certainly you put terminologies, but you need to feel about it firstly. Otherwise you will not, you will be cramming and just putting the things. You may not be able to convince the examiner, and I believe that you now the time has come that we need to put lots of efforts on anthropology, because trust me, they may be in the next few years they may try to check your actual knowledge rather than just asking the direct answers. So they might try to test you in different fields. Even in paper 2 they started indigenous people debate. I haven't expected that they will ask in that way. I like anthropology, that's why I studied. But many of my friends didn't know about it. And in similar way, there was a question, how will you study the tribal culture from art and culture? So these kinds of questions are actually, they are testing your knowledge. And similar pattern, they can repeat in paper 1 as well. And paper 1 is actually huge. They are not asking in depth, that's why it's very easy for right now. But if the moment they started asking you about synthetic theory, what about after synthetic theory? So we all will be like, okay, what to do? Even the human evolution, the Neanderthal is not normal Neanderthal. Now we talk about Homo Neanderthal. Even the evolutionary chart has been changed. So you need to, but I believe that now you need to take care of all these things, that you should prepare anthropology properly, like other subjects. You need to prepare a write-up, no doubt about it. but always try to have good case studies, good examples, and the recent example especially. It's required right now. From now on, I believe that they will actually try to test the knowledge. It's not, no more will be a paper like you will go and just write an answer, just vomit it out what you know. You have to show your analytical perspectives. Anything else?
No. So besides case studies or reference to the scholars who conducted them or name of some definitions, what more can we add so that to make a very general answer look like more anthropological?
It's not that anthropology in itself is a technical subject. You give me an example. In what kind
like,
of?
This question is very nice. PRI on women. It's more of like a GS question.
It's more of a GS, but then you have to show what you study in anthropology. What you study in anthropology, you study human beings in time and space. So, if you leave the evolutionary part, then you are studying the societies. How the societies are evolving with time. How was the society at the prehistoric period? That's how our syllabus starts. How the society was at the Indus Valley Civilization? How the society was at the Vedic period? So, how we evolved? And then we talk about the social institutions in the Indian society, or the how the social changes are being are happening. So there it happens that how this particular institution have changed the social structure. And then you have to tell them that yes, social structure is changing, then but again there's certain lacunas, this issue of Sarpanch, the institution of Sarpanchpati is still there, the PRIs are not working as per the expectation. In that way you need to show that aspect as well. And more or less, even if you write general also, you will be talking more about the social aspect. And social is anyway is anthropology.
Did you connect paper 2 with paper 1 also? In all the options, people say you can score good if you can connect paper 1 with paper 2, but it's not very easy.
No, that's what you need not to do it deliberately. The concept of Sanskritization or the dominant caste is based upon the structural functionalism. You should know about it. Then you should use it. Don't deliberately use it. Let's say the nature man spirit complex. It's all about the cultural ecology or the ecological anthropology. There you should use it, or the psychological anthropology. You should use the words, but not deliberately. You should connect the, you should take the whole syllabus as one. It will be really, and you will actually like the subject. You will feel the subject from your inside that, okay, these are the things. And especially in the paper 2, you should be very well versed with the facts and the case studies. You need it. They asked last year about the impact of Jainism or Buddhism. Buddhism on Indian society, right? Something they asked. So, in a similar article was there last year on Knapli regarding the, what it was an article on Buddhist Dalit, the Dalits who converted to Buddhism. So, their status is quite better than the Dalits who have not. So, in a way that you can come up with the educational status is this, you need to prepare. Nadeem Hasan, it has given, but the data is outdated right now. So, you need to prepare. You need to Google it. Or you can find it, I found it in the minority committee, minority commission report. You will get the data. You need to have it. In paper 2, the case studies and the facts and figures are the most important thing. Otherwise, your answer will be hollow. Anybody can go and write those answers. So you should be sure that you will be writing along with the facts, figures and the case studies. I will be releasing my notes as well, very soon, as well as my test copies. You will be able to get an idea, but I would suggest don't go through directly with that material. I believe that you should write your answer first. If you are not getting anything, then you can refer it. Take it as a reference material, not your core material.
So while making choice, like which question to write, is it really true that you should go for biology, physical and only question, even if the content is less, so we can pick
regarding this choice of question, right? Although I've covered it, that article, but I'll covered again. You know, I would always prefer to write an answer in which I am sure that if I write, I'll get good marks. That's what the choice that we have to make. So what I used to do, there are certain static areas. Archaeology. These are the most static areas. Nothing will change in that. It's very unlikely that, although you should include the recent current developments in the evolutionary studies that are happening, or the how the view of the society or view of the anthropologists on the, you know, the evolutionary part or the on the primates. Generally, they ask this culture is they ask one time that is culture unique to human beings. So you need to be well versed with the current updates, but these are the few areas that are very static. So if you write the answer, it's very likely that you will get the good marks. So in these areas, it's more about making diagrams. Make diagrams. In these are the two areas in which diagrams are the most crucial thing. Make more and more diagrams. Prepare a write-up. Nothing will change in these areas. Very unlikely. And third part was that application part, application of anthropology, the 12th chapter, paper 1. And they also ask, generally they ask one question from that particular. And it's very easy. They will ask the role of forensic anthropology, sports anthropology. It's very easy. And relate that particular topic with the the population genetics that we have, that in different areas we find, let's say sports anthropology, we find that the people from certain area are good in that particular area, good in that particular sports. So you can come up with the population, they might be genetic issues. There was a case study by, but there was a study that alpha acetylcholine 3 was used, is good for the long, for the persistent runners, and acetylcholine alpha 2 was good for the short runner. So that's how you can relate the subjects. So make sure that these are the areas that you should attempt, I personally feel, because these are the scoring areas. And although other are also static area, but not that much, are social institutions, marriage, family, kinship. Similar way in paper 2, that linguistic classification, racial classification, and again that Indian social system. So these are the areas that are quite static. The tribal India is quite dynamic, and no matter whatever you write, it's very difficult to convince anthropologists on your view on the tribals. They will be knowing much more, although they will be knowing much more on other issues as well, and tribals is something that is so dynamic that sometimes it becomes difficult to justify. But I believe that you should cover each and every part of the syllabus, but certainly attempt these areas on the first instance.
So what are your sources for Indian anthropology?
Indian anthropology, I covered Nadeem Hasnain, then Watson's notes, and what else? Then the D.K. Bhattacharya for the chapter one, then prehistory part, and the Indus Valley civilization part. And what else was there? NCRT. NCRTs, don't read to extract something out of them. Read them to understand the concepts. They have explained it very beautifully and with live examples. So small books are very good. So it's not about extracting something out of the NCRT. It's about just going through it once you will be having a very too much clarity on the different topics. Afterwards is these are mainstream books are there. Nadeem Hussain book is there. Then Vyasa's notes are there, and D.K. Bhattacharya's book is there. It's more than sufficient, and more than going through different sources, I believe that the more important thing is that you should be able to read that particular source more number of times. Have a good write up, because that matters. That would really matters. Actually, I've covered all the sources in my article on insights. I've shared all the links as well. Whatever the video links are available online, I've shared everything. And you were asking paper one, right? Paper two. And that's all. Indian Society NCRT and Nadeem Hussain's book, D.K. Bhattacharya and Vyasa's notes.
So, what is the strategy given the mains exam?
But it's same for all. You know, invest your energy where you can get something out of it. It doesn't matter that everybody is writing it, I also have to write. And thing is that in those 5 years, just what I would suggest is more than the study, your health matters more. At the end of it, you have to write an answer. And those 5 days, 8 to 10 hours, you will be going to and fro and writing the answers. So it doesn't matter much that if you can study for 2 hours more, matlab, you can study, you should study, but I feel that your health should be the more at your higher priority. So if you are feeling better, you will be thinking better way in the examination. So strategy was not as such that, but I used to keep my health as a priority at that particular time, that I should be taking proper meals and food and everything. It should be very proper in that, at least for that particular week. Well, it matters because my mind should work in that particular week in a much more efficient way than the other times. So, and rest strategy was this: try to have a good sleep and nothing more, not to too much study on those 5 days. Then doesn't matter much. Even if you study, that it's very, even if one question came, but you are not in the right kind of mind frame, or you are not very much comfortable with the topics. You are not able to think many things in the top on particular topic in the exam, it's spoiled. So just take care of your health in that particular period and have good sleep. Although it's difficult because we tend to get, we should study more. But yes, health is more important in those times. Anything on anthropology? Huh?
You were mentioning a lot of case studies on the Gujarat village or Karnataka or John Harris. Where can we find those case studies?
Case studies are actually being, you know, updated every now and then. Let's say I used to follow, not me, but Vyasa used to share certain articles, from frontline, EPW, and down to earth. From there, many case studies for tribal India will come. Many case studies for tribal India come. And for, yes, social anthropology, Indian social system, you need to find it. You need to find it from, I Google it. I just tried to get the what are the recent happenings are happening in the Jajmani system. So you will get certain links, you just go through it once. You will get certain case study. It's not that particular source you will get a case studies that on Jajmani system. You can refer once here and there from the sociology notes. They might have. I refer many notes from here and there. And from Google, there was no particular source which can provide you case studies, especially on the Indian social system. Paper 2. For that, you need to do research, a bit of research. I can share, but I feel that you should do it first. My notes will be with the VAT, sir. You can take it, but I feel that you should do all these activities. Because when you do by yourself, it will internalize. Notes can be, like my notes, there will be hundreds of notes in the market. And every notes, in one way or another way, will be talking about the similar things. It's more about that you should be writing all those things by yourself. And trust me that the people who do write all these things, they are at the much better place. When I was taking classes from VAT sir, there are about 4 people of us who are writing answers regularly, and 4 of them have actually cleared both the time. Himanshu hasn't given this year because he got 44th rank last year, IS is there. So rest of the 3 people have again given and they also cleared. So answer writing is most important part in this. Make sure you do answer writing, and for case studies, even for paper 1 as well, even the evolutionary genetics and there was a news last year regarding how genetics is is responsible for your social, how caste is actually taking as actually what was the question, how caste is playing the role in your genealogy, or the not genealogy but in your genetic structure. So there was an article by Kolkata, there was an institute, BMG, there was an institute, Biomedical Genetics. They have conducted a study on Indian society and how the genetics is being changed. Genetic structure is changing in the society. So you will get those articles. You need to just Google it. And similarly, the RN debate came quite number of times last year on, I think Hindu it came. So you need to go through some articles itself. And otherwise, you can Google it. You will get good case studies. Anything anthropology?
Once you read the article, you take notes or you just
have to save it? No. Depends upon the article. If I find that there's a certain case study that may be helpful for me, or I don't have that kind of a case study for my answers, or certain these kind of question can also be asked in the paper. So we need to see it. I generally make a note of it. I have a notebook of mine in which I have written all my case studies. And just try to have a notebook. Write all the cases at a particular place. And try to find a case study that can be used in multiple ways. So it will help you in 2 ways. Firstly, less number of things that you need to remember in the paper. Secondly, you will be able to revise it more and you will be more comfortable in the paper. And have all the case studies at one place. You can write it in each question as well, but before the mains or 20 days before the mains, just write all the case studies on one particular page or so let's 10 minutes 35 35 40. Although sometimes it's very difficult to follow this pattern, but I used to follow that way. Sometimes it's become difficult to write each and every question, but 10 markers I felt we should be doing the justice.
Sir, in tribal India questions, how much importance or weightage should be given to, say, for example, constitutional provisions or committee reports? See, as an example, say I have a question related to tribal law. So I am in a situation that I have some points from Dhaka report, some constitutional provisions. So I am in a dilemma to put which and which to leave. So what do you
say? Depends upon a particular question. I would tell you right now, because it depends upon a particular question. If question is asking how the tribal development has performed in the last 70 years, then you should talk about constitutional provisions as well. If it's only about what are the tribal problems, then you can talk about the Khaka committee report more. And you can just in the conclusion you can mention the constitutional provisions here and there. But it depends on the type of question they are asking. If you are asking that particularly about the constitutional provisions only, then you have to write. But otherwise also, it depends. Just make sure that whatever you are writing, don't go with some prejudice. Just always read a particular question, what is being asked from you. At the end of a day, that's what we need. Because what will happen in the paper, that examiner will be judging you on the base upon the answers that he was expecting. You may be writing very good answers, but it should be adhering to the needs of the question. Just make sure that whenever you are in dilemma, just read question again. Just feel that is it required for that particular question or not.
Sir,
middle of the answer, we should read the question again.
I used to do. I'm not saying that everybody should do. It depends upon the speed and lots of other factors. But I used to read again because many time it happens, we know a lot more. Generally, we know a lot of the things. So what happens in between that, we tend to write each and everything that we know, not what actually the examiner wants to know. So by reading a question again, you will be confident and you will be knowing that yes, I have to write this, I don't have to write this, even if I know it. That is important. It will save your time as well. It will make your answer more relevant and certainly it will show up in your marks as well. Anthro.
Is there any chapter in MBRMR which we can refer to enrich our answers? Though it's not compulsory.
Depends here. Matlab, from MBR and MBR linguistic anthropology you can cover. No, not much. MBR and MBR is more about understanding anthropology. It's not, there are very less topics which will actually fulfill the requirement of UPSC. There are better sources than that. So you can refer that, MBR and MBR you can refer here and there when you are not getting the feel of a subject. When you are feeling that how this subject is related to that, then you can refer it. Anthro, done.
What Sachin ji told, let me ask you, the current news which are going on in 10-15 days, do you find any scope of case study therein? Any news? There is news that has been called mini Jallianwala Bagh. Starlight, Vedanta, that is a way to look at the things. Summarize and make it a case study.